Hey everyone, it's Andy. Today I'm going to talk you through our tutorial on building a geoprocessing model. A model is a custom geoprocessing tool that utilizes several tools in a specified sequence. The purpose of the model we're going to create today is to find the proximity of an invasive grass species to human contact locations so we can mitigate their dispersal. To start building the model, we'll add a layer of campgrounds in New Zealand. These are places where people might encounter those invasive grasses. Now let's add the buffer tool. The buffer tool is going to find the search zone around the campgrounds. To begin building our tool, we'll connect the campgrounds layer to the tool. Next, we'll create a variable for the buffer distance so we can look for invasive grasses within any distance we specify. Now let's add input data for the invasive grass. This element of the model is also a variable as there are different types of invasive grasses we'll want to analyze. Now let's add another tool, Summarize Within. This tool calculates how much invasive grass is within each campground's buffer zone. The inputs to this tool are the invasive grass and the buffer zone. We'll connect both of these to the tool. We'll also create a measurement unit variable for the tool. This lets us find the amount of invasive grass in the area we've specified. We'll run the model as a geoprocessing tool. To do so, we'll flag the model variables that we want to appear on the tool interface. These are the things we want the user to be able to choose, like the buffer distance or a different type of invasive grass. Let's save the model and open it as a geoprocessing tool. By filling out the parameters, we're going to find out how much white-edged nightshade grass is within 1.5 kilometers of a campground. As you can see, we can also evaluate different human contact locations, invasive species, and buffer distances. By opening the attribute table, we can see which buffers contain the invasive grass. The model's flexibility is what makes it so powerful. You can run it as often as you like, with different sets of input data, different threshold values, and different geographic locations. If you'd like to give this tutorial a try, head over to the ArcGIS Pro Help and follow along with more detailed steps.